the lower half, to rotate the torso, to rotate the arm. I'm gonna keep the same 2 pound ball, and we're gonna do 5 throws at an RPE of about 4, maybe up to 5, warming this up slowly. But there's a little bit of a difference here. You want to make sure that you are attacking the ground with your front foot when you do it. So you're going to basically lift up the front foot, you're going to stomp it into the ground, and you're going to use that to drive your hips into rotation. Now the same cues apply. Don't move the torso and don't move the arms until the hips force them to move. It's going to feel weird for you at first, but that's the important thing to learn and to feel in this drill. Now in order to do that, you're going to need to keep your back foot basically pointed at your target so that your hips are open to about a 45 degree angle, so that when you stomp on the front foot, that energy that you're putting backwards towards second base into your hip is going to rotate your front hip backwards a little bit, and it's going to shoot your, what is your back hip, into rotation, which is what ultimately creates that stretch shortening cycle or shoulder hip separation between the core and the torso, and starts the whole chain reaction. Now, the reason this is so important is because obviously on the mound, in the delivery, you're going through a large range of motion, you're lifting your leg, you're coming down the mound, and you have to get good at hitting with your front foot, stopping the energy, and using that to actually springboard yourself into higher velocity ranges than you could get if you were just in a stagnant position. So this is really working on that mechanism of the front foot interacting with the ground and using that energy to not only stabilize, but to drive the hips more into rotation.